This is 5 more tips for Final Cut Pro. I've been putting different tips together in a single video for some time now, and I wonder whether it's better for you that these be in separate short videos, or would you prefer to see groups of tips in a single video? Please let me know in the comments below whether you'd like to opt for a single video per tip, or whether you'd like them grouped together. But for this video, there's 5 Final Cut tips. They're going to be grouped together and I'll keep them as a surprise for you. But if you would like to know what the individual tips are, you can look in the description below and there are timestamps with the titles of the video and you can click on those and go directly to them. I'm Bruce Macbryde and I can provide one-on-one personal tuition over the internet. Just click on trainingfinalcutpro.com. So let's get right into it. The first tip is about the value of gap clips and what they actually do. When doing a rough edit, I like to keep different scenes or different options of scenes separate. And I find that a gap clip is a great way of separating these sections because it's so obvious in the timeline and it's easy to find again and it doesn't sneak into the final edit. There are a couple of different ways of creating a gap. And you could use the P or the position tool to drag clips to the right. But it does require you to select all the clips to the right of the gap and also remember to return to the A tool after you've finished. By far the easiest way to create a gap is to simply type Option plus W and a short gap is inserted at the playhead. You can shorten or lengthen this as you would any clip because the gap is actually a clip, it's just got no video or audio in it. Hence it fills the space and stops the magnetic timeline snapping shut between the two clips that the gap separates. The next two tips are about precision editing of the timeline and they use shortcut keys. The first set of keys is the comma and the period, that's a full stop key. And these are for moving the clip, as opposed to the second set of shortcuts that moves the playhead. So let's look at the comma and the period keys. Select the left or the right side of the clip in the timeline. The end will turn yellow and you'll be able to lengthen or shorten the clip by pressing the comma or the period key for one video frame at a time. The other way of moving a clip is to select on a connected clip, and in this case I'm going to use a title clip. The whole clip's outlined in yellow, so use the period or comma key and move the clip relative to the main timeline, left or right. Now a little bit more obscure is doing the same thing with a clip in the main timeline. If you select the clip in the magnetic timeline, the selected clip is moved, and the clips either side are shortened or lengthened. In other words, the clip is moved up and down the timeline and the clip either side fills the gaps. Watch the left side of the yellow outline clip when I press the period key. The clip to the left of the selected clip lengthens. Now look at the right side of the yellow outline clip when I press the period key. The clip to the right of the selected clip shortens. I'll use a few presses of the comma and the period key so you can review what's happened. The second set of keys are the keyboard arrow keys that move the playhead as opposed to moving the clip. The arrow keys move the playhead one frame at a time. If you zoom into the timeline, that's press the command plus keys several times, you'll see a grey shaded area to the right of the playhead. And that's the space that one frame takes up in that zoomed in view. Each time you use the arrow key, you jump a full frame of video, which is the smallest item that a video can have. Just think of it as a single atom size of the video. And now the fourth tip. Even though the video can only be edited one frame at a time, you can edit the audio at a subframe rate. In other words, you can adjust audio within a single frame of video. To do this, select Ctrl plus Z. You'll now be able to skim the playhead within the single frame of video. If you wanted to reduce the volume of audio within that single frame of video, click three dots in the video frame holding the Option key and drag the center dot down. You can see that this has happened within the video. That's only part of the audio has been reduced within that full video frame. You can move one subframe at a time by selecting Command plus right arrow or Command plus left arrow. And I'll use Command right arrow. Watch the playhead move within the video frame and also watch the audio meters jump. The fifth tip is also about audio, and this is the reference audio view. In simple terms, this shows you the actual audio waveforms before you made any adjustments or corrections. It's turned on in the preferences, select editing, and select the show reference waveforms checkbox. Now lower the volume and you'll see the original waveforms as a reference in a ghostly background view. I look forward to reading your comments before making any more of these tip videos, whether these be single tips in a single video or in a group of tips within a video. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell. There are new videos every Sunday.